Hare Krishna, Krishna Abhishek Prabhu. Welcome back to the Monks Podcast. It's auspicious day of our Bhaktivinoda Thakur today, so I thought that we could discuss something about him and especially about how he has positioned himself in a way that his outreach becomes effective. So we could discuss about his how he positioned himself politically with respect to the ruling government at that time, intellectually with respect to the ethos, and culturally with respect to the existing culture and religious establishment. And especially what we can learn, what we have done as a movement, and what we can do individually while positioning ourselves also, we can draw some lessons from that. Is that okay?
Yeah, that's totally fine. Thank you for having me on your podcast.
Please complete. You're saying something?
Oh, I thank you for having me on your podcast.
Yeah, several devotees appreciated our previous discussion, and especially the specific examples of Bhaktivinoda Thakur's broad-mindedness were something which many had not heard of. I think there's a lot we could discuss about Bhaktivinoda Thakur in the next also. So, yeah. I believe you also wanted to share something about some developments. Would you like to do it just with Bhaktivinoda Thakur's place? Like to do it now? Or
yeah, anything? Sure. Sure, I can say it now.
Yeah.
I can say it now. So for the last 12 years, I have been regularly in touch with my friends at Birnagar in West Bengal, India, which is Bhaktivinoda Thakur's birthplace. And they had invited me on several occasions to become their trustee. This year I accepted it, and they passed a resolution inviting me to start a research center there, and that is something I'm going to dedicate myself to for at least the next 4 or 5 years till it flourishes. At least that's my hope. And I wanted to share on this special occasion the interactions between Srila Prabhupada and Prabhupada Lalita Prasad Thakur,
so
who was
they,
a brother
they,
of...
Just a minute, sorry. By they, are you referring to the...
Sorry?
They who are the trustees of that place, are they the descendants of... Who
yes.
are the descendants of Lalita Prasad Thakur?
Descendants, they are mostly followers of Lalita Prasad Thakur, who has maintained that place. But there are also other places like Bhakti Bhavan and his, several places that where people know each other, and they kind of either directly or indirectly connected with the bloodlines of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, but also more importantly, actually, the spiritual lines of Bhaktivinoda Thakur. And there were several. Bhaktivinoda Thakur was a great kind of outreach acharya for Gaudiya Vaishnavism.